Hello and welcome to Kraaft It Live. I'm your host, Heather Crafter. Do you want to see what Heather Crafter looks like today? This is what she looks like today. Hello, how are you? It is a little bit crazy getting ready for this show sometimes. We're sitting in here, just Debbie and I chatting away, having a good time, watching all of the comments go, because you guys are having a good time over there. And then I realized, oh, I don't have something out. And at 2 minutes till, I ran over to grab something real fast. So anyway, hi, how are you? Debbie, you want to say hi?
Hi, everybody. Yeah, we were gabbing. Can you imagine that? Yes, you can.
What's really great is that I miss my friend Debbie. I miss my Debbie. Yeah, that's what it is. I miss my Debbie. I know you guys have missed her, too. I'm glad that you're here, Debbie. And I breathe a lot easier when you're here. I don't know if you realize that or not, but I do.
I don't know why that is, but I'm happy to help you breathe.
Yeah. Well, you do all the hard work. That's why. All I have to do is craft. That's the easy part. So, speaking of crafting, would you like to know what we're going to work on today?
I would like to know what you're working on today. I know we're altering something.
Yes, all month long we've been altering things. Last week, I know you missed this. Oh, you missed a good show. Jay altered some glass and turned little square mirrors into beautiful coasters that many people said they refused to use them as coasters, but do you know who won them?
Who won? Who won?
Shell C of Arizona won them. Now, I will say that wasn't the first winner. The first winner was one of Jay's friends, and he refused to take them because he said he can have Jay's goodies anytime. So he gave them up so that way another winner could be drawn, and we drew right there in the Aftercrafter party because he actually got a phone call. Jay's in the Aftercrafter party. He gets a phone call. I don't want him. That's not what he said. He said, somebody else needs to take those. So he made me draw again, and we drew the name, and Shell was the winner. And then do you know what? I gave away the prize package yesterday on Monday Meanderings, if you missed that.
I want to know who you gave it away to.
It was Sandra. Sandra artfully made one. She did some really cool stuff with Snoopy. Believe it or not, she used some peanuts. I think it was a calendar she cut up and altered quite a few things with that. So, man, the submissions this month.
Really?
Yeah, some great stuff.
Are they posted over on the website?
Yeah, no, on the website?
Kraaft Shaak website, the KSD November?
No, thanks for pointing out that I've not done anything in my blog all month. Thanks for pointing that out. Actually, that's, you know what, that leads into why we're taking a break for the rest of the year. Today's the last show of the year because I have not blogged at all. I've not been able to read blogs. I've not been able to blog to my own blog. I mean, it's just crazy. So we're going to take a break. We're going to realign some priorities and be able to do some of that. But yeah, no, if you want to see some of those submissions for the Kraaft Shaak drawing in November, you'll have to search the hashtag KSDNOV and you will find some pretty awesome things that have been altered this month.
Excellent. I'm going to do it right now.
Of course you are. I know. See, this is why I love working with her, you guys. Anyway, enough of that. Anything that you want to talk about? I mean, you haven't been here, so you could actually talk all day if you wanted to. I'd let you.
I could talk all day. I want to tell you guys that I have been loving looking at the community. I've been involved in a Plus Your Business project and been traipsing the streets of Eagle, Colorado on that. But I come home, I look at the community, I look at the beautiful artwork, and my gosh, I can't believe I say this every time, but the talent in the crafters community over on Google Plus, amazing. And then recently, Tina Van Eyck, she's on the show right now. She put up some wonky houses, so that's going to be my next stamp because, as you know, I've got the stamping stuff now. So really good to see everybody so involved and so busy. So just I've missed you guys, but know that I'm lurking. I'm kind of, you know. What do they call it? What's the word? Not lurking, but stalking. There we go.
Oh, you're stalking. That's much more positive than lurking. Yeah. You know what? I did want to chat about one thing before we actually switch the camera and move over to stuff. So, if you find some comments, we'll take those while I switch the camera. But I did want to talk about perspective. This is something that comes up in art quite a bit. But I'm not talking about, you know, the way that you draw a house to show the perspective. That's not what I mean by perspective. I mean the way that you and I look at things. Our perspectives can be very different. One of the things that I wanted to talk about with perspective is take a look at this. Okay, when I hold the mug like this, it kind of sort of looks, let's see if I can do it. Your perspective might be that the mug is sort of floating. You can see my hand there, but you can't really see how I'm holding it. So your perspective is maybe what's the purpose of this? It almost seems useless. Like if this mug had hot coffee in it, how would you hold this thing? But from my perspective, I can see the handle quite clearly. My perspective shows just how useful this device actually is. So just keeping that in mind, I want you all to enter the holiday season, enter whatever season of life you might be in, with the idea that perspectives are different for each of us on either side of the camera and on either side of the situation. So just keep that in mind, and we can move on.
While you're moving on, speaking of perspectives, let me just bring up today's message, if I can, which is, your life may be the only Bible another might read. Live it well. And this is kind of a paraphrase of 1 Thessalonians. And when Heather read that message to me this morning, I was like, wow, that really is true. You might be reflecting, you know, the love of God or not. So just know that you've got that kind of power. And, you know, from other people's perspective, they just see you as a really, really good person, which might be the only Bible that they read. So I thought that was a great one. I loved it.
I thought it was pretty good, too. Now, why is it not coming off of my screen?
It came off of me, but it didn't come off of you.
Yeah, click it again.
All right.
Sometimes the technology is just so fun. All right, we can see now. Yay.
I think it's good. Yeah.
All right, so I am going to be altering today some toilet paper rolls. That's what we're going to be working on. Now, these served their purpose quite well, I will say, at one point in time, and then once that moment of glory was over, I decided to save them. And I've been saving these for a long, long time, and it turns out, we had a discussion about this recently, that apparently they're making toilet tissue without these tubes in it. It's like tubeless toilet tissue. Whoever came up with that idea should be shot, but we will go into that in another dime. Someday these are going to be valuable. That's what I've come up with in my mind. But anyway, okay, so I've got a bunch of them, and I've done some prep work ahead of time, but what I want to show you as I bring these out is I have an idea to create something that's going to hold my tools on my workstation, and I've already pre-made something else that I'll show you in a little bit. But for this purpose, we're going to show you 12 of them put together this way, and some foam core. You guys know what foam core is, right?
Is it like styrofoam?
Well, it's like a poster board that it's like foam is sandwiched between the poster board. So it's a very thick, lightweight poster board. This is just a piece of it, but they come in pretty large sheets. Have you ever seen that before? It's foam sandwiched in there.
Yeah, they're pretty easy to cut, and the surface is smooth.
Exactly. So you could paint, you could stamp, you could do anything on this thing. You could even cover it in paper, and we're going to show you that in a bit, okay? So this is my base, basically, of the premise of what I'm going to do. And I'll show you measurements and all that kind of thing. What I suggest you do is not worry about what numbers I used, but rather put your rolls together. If you're going to attempt this project, put your rolls together and use the measurements of what you have, because one thing I have found is that tissue rolls are different. They're all different. Even from the same exact company, they're all different. So let's see if I can move these out of the way without making a big old mess. All right, so here's a tip on how to cut your foam core. Pretty simple. You'll need a ruler, an X-Acto knife, and a grid like this, some sort of cutting grid, okay? If you have one that's bigger than your wood or your foam core piece, this will make this much simpler. And what I tend to do is line up this bottom line here with any one of the grids, and then the left side with any one of these grids here. You could do it down in the corner if that's easiest so that you can use those marks however you want to do it, but for me, I just tend to use the center of the board the most. And then my ruler, as you'll notice, is longer than my piece, and you'll see why in a second. Let's say I'm going to trim this down to be 6 inches long, okay? I can tell at a glance, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 inches, I know this line right here is where I want to cut it. I have it lined up here and here, so I know this will be straight. Line up my ruler with this grid line here to here. Notice I'm not having to mark it with a pencil or anything. Taking my X-Acto blade. Now don't freak out. I know somebody out there is going to be like, ah, I just got a sharp object. That would be my husband. That would be my husband who would say that. Okay, so anyway, you start with the blade up against the ruler, and that will keep it nice and straight so you don't have any tipping or anything. Put the blade up against the ruler and just carefully bring it towards yourself. Nice and easy. You don't have to cut it on the first try. Do it again. Do it again until you've cut through. And usually on the third pass, sometimes four, I get it. And I'm not really putting much pressure. I'm really not. I didn't go all the way through that time, but there it is. So there, that's the easy way to cut your foam core and get a nice straight cut. Now that I've told you all of that, my husband helped me cut all the pieces that I needed last night, and they weren't cut that way. But we won't tell him, okay? So let me move that out of the way.
So are you going to tell us how they were cut, or was it a good thing or a bad thing or what?
No, he didn't. He didn't cut them straight. Can you see
that? Oh, that's all right. You know what?
Sometimes we love that he helped.
Yep, you can't look a gift horse in the mouth.
Gift horse. That's what I'm going to tell him you called him. Okay, so this is how I came up with my measurements, okay? I cut multiple pieces, and we're going to do the first one. The bottom piece is all 12 rolls on top of it. Okay, so whatever this measurement is with all 12 rolls. I'm not sure if I'm saying all of this right, so if you don't understand what I'm saying, please ask Debbie.
Well, fortunately, it's in video, so we can watch.
Okay, good. All right, so all 12 of them, and I measured from here to here and here to here, and that's what we cut. So that will create the very first base. Now, I want these to all kind of step up. And this being a bad angle for the camera, I want them to be elevated. This row to be a little bit higher, and this row to be a little bit higher than that. Okay? In order to do that, we needed to cut some more pieces. So I took I took one row off. This is just fun playing with the toilet paper rolls, okay? All right, so take one row off and cut two of them that size. Two pieces that size. That's going to give our elevation for that set of them. And then one row and cut two of those. Okay? So now what we have are...
Did you freeze?
Lower. This is even lower.
Oh, there we go.
They will all set like that. And hopefully you can see that. And I'll be able to show you more as we go along, because then they'll glue them all in place, okay? And I'm not giving measurements because your toilet paper rolls are going to be different. Now, the final four pieces that I cut were the end pieces to cap off the sides. Once we get this glued together, you'll see what I mean. this is as tall as this top piece here, and then one for the front and one for the back, and they cap off the whole thing. All right, now we're going to take some glue. We're not going to make this base just yet, because one thing that we do need to do is cover our toilet paper rolls. And you can see that I have added some paper, decorative paper, just to make them look cute. And I've got a couple here that I haven't done yet. So for this,
you know, I thought I was losing my mind. I saw the yellow ones, and I thought, did I turn my head and she did that without me seeing it?
No, I did 10 of them before we got together today, because I figured you didn't want to watch me glue them all. I'll show two to show how I glued these, because this might be a tip you might want to know about. I took my favorite glue, you know my favorite glue, and any liquid glue will be great, but you want something that's fast drying. And you want to be able to put on a really fine tip line here. Let's see if I can zoom in. All right, so basically, this is my glue, and I'm just going to put on a fine, a fine line right there at the edge, very fine line. And I'm going to do all the edges, and I want to get as close to the edge as possible, because I really don't want any extra sticking out when I put this together. Really fine line of glue inside. This is the reason why I couldn't do it before. Okay, there we go. Pick that up, and here's what I did. I put this on so that I could tell this edge and this edge are lined up. Now, I cut these to be the exact height, and I just did 6 inches because I knew it would wrap around and be okay. And then I'm just twirling it towards myself as I'm pushing it onto the roll here. So we're just rolling it on. And you do need to kind of work quickly with the fast-acting glue. And just like that, it's on. All right, one more time.
I'm going to read a comment here from Beth. She said, excited to see what is going to happen with the toilet paper rolls. The girl guides want them tonight, so this is good timing. I'm not sure who the girl guides are.
Oh, I don't know.
So, Beth?
She'll explain, I'm sure.
Explain, yes. She says, I might steal some back from those sweet little girls. Mwah!
Oh, it's probably like Girl Scouts.
Maybe.
That they're collecting toilet paper rolls, and she's saying maybe they won't get them all.
Yeah, keep 12 for yourself, Beth.
Well, and I will tell you that the other thing that I made, well, this is... I'll get to it in a minute. Now notice this one was kind of wonky. It had been squished. It doesn't matter. This paper adds kind of a little bit more stiffness to these, so it'll make it a little bit more stable, which is nice. So there we go. Okay, now I'm going to back out the camera just a little bit more. All right.
There's some conversation going on here about the extinction of toilet paper rolls.
I know, I'm telling you, this is the conversation of the month. We've been having it all month long. All right, so the pieces that you want to start with for assembling this project are the two smallest ones. We're going to glue those together like a sandwich, okay? And I'm just using my hot glue gun, which I can unplug, and I might as well because the cord is caught on something. There we go. All right. So, and I don't know. I'm not a hot glue expert, so don't ask me any questions about the hot glue. Oh, that's not fair, is it? Make sure I'm still on camera, I guess. Okay, so I'm just going to blob a bunch. That's a technical term. Blob a bunch of hot glue down, and then press this thing down on top of that, and squish it together. Also,
that's
a technical term.
Yeah.
And see, this is where not cutting it straight really matters, but...
Well, I was just going to say, Nanette just offered up a suggestion. She says, fill the edges of the ones that aren't straight. Oh, file the edges. I'm sorry, Nanette. File the edges of the ones that aren't straight. I don't know
That'd be a good idea, but we're not messing with that. There's no need. Yeah, it doesn't need to be perfect. So now I am using my silicone mat to press this on because there's a little bit of extra glue squishing out. So I'm not sure if you can see that. I've got my silicone mat here. And you can use, like, you know, they've got those baking sheets that are made out of silicone.
That's what I'll use.
That. Yeah. This was, I think, $4 next to the hot glue gun. It's nice. I like to put my hot glue gun on it like that, and then when it drips off, it drips onto this. I like that. But okay, so there is that one glued together. The excess, I don't know if you can see it because it's clear, but the excess that oozed out is flat and cool right there, will not interfere with our assembly. All right, we're going to do that same thing with the larger pieces. Another exciting Kraaft It Live where Heather is gluing. Almost burned herself with the hot glue gun, so that almost was some excitement there.
That would have been exciting. We could have heard you yell and
glue a little bit. Then you guys would have known what Bible I read, I guess, but whatever. All right, here we go.
Oh, Beth did get back to us. Andy knew that the Girl Guides is the English version of Girl Scouts, and Beth said, yes, it's Girl Scouts, but in Canada, it is a sisterhood of Girl Guides.
Those Canadians, I tell you what, they just make everything special. All right, so now I've got my final base piece, and I'm going to glue that first step onto it. See how difficult this is?
That's really hard.
You almost need an engineering degree, but not quite. Now, the key here is that you want to keep these edges flush because we are going to be putting pieces. So as that glue sets, it does move a little bit. But we want this edge to be flush and this edge to be flush as much as we can. Again, that's where this using your countertop helps, because as it dries, that edge is flush thanks to what I'm pushing down on here. Okay? And we're going to do the same thing with this one. And I need to get another glue stick.
You can buy and buy the gross, I think, right? I mean, it seems like I bought one bag a year ago and still have a ton left.
Oh, I tell you what, I thought the same thing until I started, like, what the heck's her name? Sylvia. She does those videos, you know, the Keep It Simple Sylvia videos. Man, yeah. That woman uses a lot of glue, a lot of hot glue. Now all of a sudden I have I needed to buy a new hot glue gun because my other one was just too cheap. And then it was hurting my hand to use it. And I realized the tools, if you don't use the proper tools, man, it makes a difference. All right, so let's go ahead and show you how to put the... I'm going to get another glue stick before I do this next part because I know I'm going to be in the middle of it and need one.
Yeah.
And you know I'm going to drop something here any second now.
Come on.
I did it without dropping. Ha, sorry. All right, so there's a couple of glue sticks. We should be okay now. All right, just to show you how this is going to go, we put all of them on the little stairs. And they all fit on there so nicely. Isn't that cute? Oh, well, probably not from your angle. It's not so much. See the idea here?
Very nice.
Okay, now I am just going to take, again, some more hot glue. And you might want to be particular about which direction the slits of paper go on your rolls. You might want to care about that. You know me better than that, but just
so
a
like
little bit of glue.
You would hide the seams maybe between the paper rolls, the toilet paper rolls.
Yeah, because when they touch each other, that'll disappear. So can you see that? Am I showing it properly? There's
yep.
a seam here. There's a seam here. Glue them together. You won't see it.
Got it.
Okay. And I'm just going to put a little bit of glue there and a little bit along this one here. And that's all I'm going to do to glue this part on. And I'm going
okay,
to do
so
that all the
you
way
didn't
across.
Put any glue on the edge, on the bottom edge then, huh?
No. And the reason why is because, like right now, I'm going to put some on here. See how it moves a little bit?
Yeah.
We want to be able to move it a little bit, just in case.
Okay.
And some more on the edge. This will help it fit better. If I were to glue the bottom edge down and do it wrong, it's like there for good.
Then it's wrong for good. Okay.
And it's really not that bad because it's hot glue. I mean, you can just pull this stuff up and start over if you want to, but nobody wants to do that. This project should not take you very long. Although I thought we'd be done by now, so it's kind of funny. All right, and as that is setting up, you might want to take your time and go a little bit slower, but this is live television, people. I can't be taking time. All right, here we go. All right, so all four of them are now glued. And while it sets up.
And Sherry says, she says, love watching whatever Heather is doing, even if it's gluing. So,
you know, I'm going to have to start paying these people because they're just being so nice to me. I have to apologize for yesterday's Monday meanderings because there a couple of things took place. I got wonderful notes from many of you saying how much you really do appreciate the show, and I didn't want anyone to think that I was talking to you regulars who just love the show and show up every week. You guys make me feel great all the time, so thank you very much. I appreciate all of your kind words. And I even received some donations, and I want those of you who are watching who did this wonderful thing of donating to the Craft Shack for prizes and whatnot, I appreciate that. That says a whole lot to me. It might have been just a tiny bit to you, and I know I got a message that this is not very much money, but I wanted you to have it. And my response to that is your little donation is huge to me, so I appreciate it. I really do, and it helps me be able to give away as many prizes as we possibly can. And I thank you for that.
And it was yesterday on Monday Meanderings then that you were that you gave away the prize for November, right?
Yes, that's what I gave away. The prize package was a bunch of things to alter.
I remember seeing the picture. I don't know if it was in the community or on your blog, but all the different like little boxes and things that could be decorated and altered. Yeah, it's cool.
Yeah, so I gave that away. And it's really nice that people recognize that stuff does cost money, and so does the postage and everything. So that was really sweet to receive some donations. And that it just reiterates that you do really appreciate things, and I am grateful for that. I know that you guys do. And I didn't mean to give the impression that in yesterday's rant that I was unappreciated. I didn't mean that. All the private messages that I received were pretty special, but go ahead, Debbie.
A little humor from Michael, because, you know, we can always count on him for that.
Yes.
He said, I went to the bathroom 15 extra times this week just so I could follow along with the show.
Well, that's a whole nother topic, a whole nother discussion there, Michael.
Well, and then Sylvia followed up with TMI, Michael.
Exactly.
I thought it was funny.
I know where he's going with his toilet paper usage, but come on, Michael, we didn't need to know. Oh, that's too funny. I love it. All right, so I'm just...
Over in Google, I did a search for KSD November, KSD NOV,
yeah,
and pulled up an entire page of cool cool entries.
I know, I'm telling you, they were amazing submissions, and several people submitted a couple of times, which I want everyone to know, you can submit as many times as you want. The more times you use that hashtag, the better. And you know, when you link to the community in your blog or to the Craft Shaak page, to the website, any of that stuff, that's just so very helpful for people to be able to find us and to connect with us more. So I appreciate you doing that, and I know that other people have appreciated it because they've found us and they've joined us, and we've all benefited from our new members and all that kind of wonderful stuff. So thank you. Keep it up. Don't stop. Keep on trucking.
Hold that sideways now. I want to see the tears. Oh, cool.
See how it's staggered?
Yep.
All right, and now we're going to finish the front and the edges using our little skinny ones here. And it's just the same process. Hot glue on the sides first because the sides are shorter. So I did that on purpose.
Oh, you mean you cut the pieces like the lengthwise is slightly shorter?
Well, these sides here are exactly the same width of the package, and then this will cover so that you'll, when you look at it, you'd see a finished edge. Whoops.
I got it.
All right. Hold the phone, Debbie. I'm busy gluing.
I'm sorry.
Try that again. I need to put the glue on this part, I think, because I missed. And watch me burn my fingers.
No, don't.
Should I push the mute button before I do that? Okay, here we go. And again, darn it. I did not have that one cut high enough. That one should have gone up to here. Can you see that?
Oh, yeah, to cover the base. I see what you
And see, again, wonderful helper. Thank you so much, honey. I appreciate your help. Mm-hmm. I may end up cutting new ones and putting those parts on, but...
Well, you know what's nice, though, Heather, is that if you did everything exactly perfectly and made it look really easy, we wouldn't be able to get to learn from your mistakes. So
I know sometimes I mistake on purpose, you know. This is one of those times. It's all it is to it. I just mistake on purpose. So there I just use my silicone mat to wipe off. It's like a rag. Yeah, if you believe that I did that on purpose, you're nuts. Whatever. All right, so here we go. The back part. I have a feeling this is not going to go high enough either.
Michael says, these look like the pipes on the church organ. And you know, when you were stacking them, it reminded me of choir singers standing on bleachers.
Oh.
I think we all have Christmas on our mind.
You know, and that's a good thing, because think about this. This would be a really cool gift for a crafter. I'm just saying, if you know anybody. And actually, you don't even have to use it for a crafter. Think about an office desk or something like that you could use this for, because pencils, pens, scissors, it'll all fit in there just fine.
Well, now, did you say that at the beginning, what you were actually making? Did I just miss it? Because the anticipation was building here, wondering, what is this going to be?
Well, I did say desk organization, I thought. Maybe I just thought it in my head, but it doesn't matter. I mean, I wasn't trying to be coy about it. So here it is. It's just basically a foam core box. It's very lightweight. See? Can't you tell on TV how lightweight that is? Yeah, whatever. Anyway, so this is basically it. Now you can make it prettier by adding ribbon or cut some paper. Here's some matching paper we could cut to cover this foam core up.
That would be one way then to let that go just a little bit higher.
Exactly.
Yeah, even out the edge.
And it would cover up that whoopsie on this side that, of course, I did on purpose so you knew what not to do, of course. Right. Okay, so now here, let's just, you know, let's just, we could use it like this. We could put our colored pencils and put them in by warm and cool colors. We could do anything we wanted like that. Scissors work really well in there. Check that out. See how they fit? Very nice, right?
Very good, yeah.
Let me show you one that I had already made and finished with paper and did in a very different direction. So this is actually a triangle. I made it like a pyramid. And I didn't have to cover these because they were down inside the edges. So the edges are totally covered. And I did it this way so that it could be on my desk like this, and everything is horizontal. These are my alcohol markers, and they have to be stored horizontally. I also wanted to be able to take it places and not have everybody fall out. So now I can take this upstairs and set it down on the table next to me, and I can see all my colors. I've got them sorted by cools in this area and warms in this area. My neutrals are all in the center so that I can just at a glance grab the ones that I want and be able to see them. Pretty simple. And I can take this anywhere I want.
And they don't go rolling around.
And they don't go rolling around, which was a big issue, actually. So that I did, and I like it because it's a pretty neat... you could actually make these, if you wanted to, you can make them more like a box so that they could stack on top of each other. But I really like that it was a triangle. I don't know why. I think because there's no way that this is going anywhere. I think that's why I liked it so much.
Yep.
But anyway, right. That was my thinking.
Now, Heather, remind me, because I'm sitting in the green room with you, can the folks who are in the room see who's in the room if they're not comments?
You know what I didn't do this time around? I didn't change their view for that, so they have been able to see.
Okay, all right. I was just wondering, because I know sometimes they can't, and I wanted to just shout out to everyone who was here, because you got a room full.
Yeah. Yeah, they should be able to see all the names, and I apologize for the screen real estate that's been taken away. Michael just said that the show stopped for him, so I don't know if the show stopped for anyone else, but apparently not.
It didn't stop for me.
So, not that Michael can hear me, but sorry about that, buddy. Anyway, so that is what I decided to do with my toilet paper roll collection. And I did have one more project that I wanted to show, but that is, I think, something that's going to have to wait for a different time than now, because it actually has to do with flattening these things out and turning them into a mini album. And I just didn't have anything prepared in enough advance to be able to show you that, and it's quite a lengthy process. So instead, I thought I would just show you how I made my organizer for my alcohol markers and for my desk that sits behind me, so I have tools on that desk and don't have to keep getting up to come over here and get the ones that are at this workstation. So any questions out there or anything?
Oh, we've got lots of comments. Let me see here. I have to filter my thread here. Andrew made reference to pipe organs also. Yeah, I don't know if you mentioned desk organizer at the beginning, but that's what it was looking like. So Andrew says, glad that Debbie is back to civilization. Oh, I tried to change that to his comment, but the comments are working kind of weird.
Well, I saw it.
Did you? Okay. Glad that Debbie is back to civilization. And actually, Andrew, you know what? I'm at yet another house sitting gig, and the internet's not quite as fast as what I have at home, but I'm just happy that I'm able to be here. Sousa says, blimey, I managed to lock myself out, but I'm back in. Apparently she was just getting in and out of the show. I wanted to say the word blimey.
I love it. So, I love it.
Susan R. says that she's got lots of those in a box, and I'm assuming she's talking about the toilet paper rolls. You know what? I've got lots of them in a box, too. I used to teach Awanas, and it seemed like we used toilet paper rolls for a lot of stuff, and I just keep collecting them. So this one just cracked me up. Sherry says, Heather, we need to write you a theme song.
I said that she needs to also perform it, though.
I think that would be
ideal to have the crafters community perform said theme song, don't you?
That would be fun. Yeah, that would be fun. I'm sorry, go ahead.
Oh, I was just going to say, I wanted to show you just the size of it and from a different angle, just how better how better view this is from this camera. Right. Than the overhead camera. For some projects, the overhead camera is not so good. But so then, once I finish, putting paper on that, that'll look really nice.
Very good.
Yep.
Very good.
And we are doing After Crafter Party. We are doing that. So if anybody does want to come in and hang out for a little bit before we say goodbye on this 2014 season of Kraaft It Live. We'll be back in January. Yeah.
Did you say season finale?
Yeah, that's what today is. Yeah.
Okay. Because I it bleeped out. The audio bleeped out. But
I was cursing, so it was censored.
So anybody who wants to be in the After Crafter Party, just hang here after the show ends, and then Heather or I will click the button that brings you in.
Yep. Yeah,
that how it works,
that's,
right?
That's exactly how it works. So, you know, honestly, I thought that this show was going to go short. I didn't know how short. So we're not taking up an entire hour, unless you guys have questions or things you want to chat about or anything like that. Otherwise, I think we might just be wrapping it up and saying Happy Thanksgiving, Merry Christmas, and all of the wonderful things, and then it'll be Happy New Year, because I won't see you until after the New Year.
Right, and I see that you've got the shows already posted on the Kraaft Shaak blog. If you go to Watch It Live tab, your January shows are already posted, so go over there, just pop the little radio buttons, and those you'll get the email with any information you might need, so that you can remember when the dates are.
Yeah, and you know what? You can actually click the check all button. If you click the check all button, you'll register for all of them in one fell swoop. You'll get an email that will let you know and remind you. And then, of course, we send out regular reminders, too, that tell you. So if you check your emails, you won't forget. I won't let you.
Hey, you know what? I'm just going to see as how we have a couple of extra minutes, if it's okay. Yeah. I'm just going to go over and demonstrate. In case you're not watching, in case you're watching this on YouTube and you're not familiar with the website or the Google Plus. So am I on screen right now?
You are. You're showing it to us. I'm going to actually click your screen so that's what we see. Yep.
Okay. So it's the live watch here on the Kraaft Shaak website. And you scroll down. I clicked the little tweet button today, too, so that tweeted out that I was at the show. That was kind of fun. And then, oh, here you go. Yeah, you've got the January 6th, 13th, 20th, 27th. Check all. I'm going to register right now. There we go. And then I will get the reminders and all that stuff, right?
That's right. That's
there we
right.
go. Simple as that. I'm registered for all the shows in January. You can stop screen sharing me now.
All right. If you say so.
Uh-huh.
Very cool. Very cool. So I'm not seeing any. Oh, Tina says, I like the pin storage. And then I lost it just like that. Poof. Comments awake. I like the pin storage. After Crafter, please. I love that when you guys say that. That's awesome. And happy Thanksgiving to you too, Lon, and Christmas and everything else. So thank you very much. We appreciate you joining us. We appreciate you being here. Hopefully it wasn't a letdown. I really wanted to be able to show you this very lightweight way to store the pins. And I'm even thinking about putting a handle on it so that I could carry it when I go upstairs. Doesn't that seem like a good idea?
I think so, yeah. A little bucket. Triangular bucket.
I like it. I don't know why. It's goofy. I think that's why. But and it's also pretty. You know, it's not just unique. It's pretty too, like me. Oh, that was funny. Okay, so on that note, I think we'll say goodbye. I think we'll say see you in 2015, and you still altering things. Alter away. We like that. Go ahead, Ann. Go ahead, Debbie.
I was going to say you froze for a second, but maybe just for me.
Just kidding. All right. That's enough of that. I'm getting goofy. I think the weather is getting to me. I don't know if I told you guys this or not, but it is snowing. It's been snowing all day. Oh, that's why I have the big white sweatshirt on, because it's snowing. Ugh. Anyway, I guess I don't really want to say goodbye.
We've got lots of people waiting to get into After Crafter, so, you know, wrap it up, lady.
I'm going to sign it off. Join us in the Crafters community on G+, and, of course, we're on pretty much every social network. So, you know, there's really no excuse. You can connect with us anywhere. Look for us anywhere. All right? Bye.
Bye.